From the nation that brought you the Black Death, the SARS outbreak of 2002, and the swine flu pandemic of 2018, comes the year's newest, hottest plague, the deadly coronavirus of 2020. It's a new year and a new decade, which means only one thing: new you, new pandemic. But what in the world is the new coronavirus ravaging China and now making landfall in the United States? A coronavirus is a catch-all term for a virus that infects the nose, sinuses, mouth, and throat. SARS, for example, is a coronavirus that made the leap from animals to humans and pretty quickly went mainstream on a tour of the Southeast Asia region. Most of these viruses are limited to giving you mild, cold-like symptoms, but others, like Middle East Respiratory Syndrome and the infamous SARS, can actually be deadly. This new outbreak of a coronavirus got its start in the city of Wuhan, one of China's largest cities, with a population of 11 million. It was just a small-town virus with dreams of living a big city life, and soon it had infected dozens of Wuhan's residents, though the real number is impossible to estimate given the flu and cold-like symptoms of the virus. What became immediately obvious, though, was the fact that this virus was far deadlier than the cold or the flu, and the elderly were at particular risk. The first victim of the coronavirus was a 61-year-old man who died on January 9th. This was followed by the deaths of two more on January 15th and 18th. The fourth man to die was an 89-year-old man admitted to the hospital a day earlier with severe breathing issues. From there, the death toll continued to climb, reaching 25 deaths due to the virus. The World Health Organization convened to discuss measures to protect the global population from a possible pandemic, but ultimately decided that the virus was not virulent enough to warrant an international emergency. Despite this, China has instituted an unprecedented lockdown on Wuhan and other affected cities, enacting a travel ban that's now affecting approximately 33 million people. The lockdown is seen as critical, given the fact that the Chinese New Year was pending at the time of the lockdown, and authorities feared the spread of the virus across the rest of China and beyond. The authoritarian Chinese government was perhaps better suited for locking down entire cities than other world governments, but the restriction of information regarding the virus has angered many Chinese citizens. In a bid to not create a panic over the virus, the Chinese government has kept the story out of its state-run media as much as possible. And Chinese citizens, afraid for their health and angry with their government, have turned to social media to try and inform themselves. Because social media isn't exactly the number one source for fact-checked information, many Chinese citizens have in fact panicked exactly the way the Chinese government had tried to prevent in the first place with the information blackout. The American CDC has responded to the coronavirus outbreak by screening passengers at five of the nation's largest airports who come in on flights from known Chinese contagion sites. The service has developed a field test that can tell if a person is infected and is hoping to spread that knowledge with international partners in a bid to help combat the potential epidemic. While the American government is not considering a ban on travel to affected Chinese cities, it has issued a Level 3 travel alert, the highest possible, warning travelers to consult with their physicians and take all possible precautions to avoid infection while in affected areas. The news of the first American infection, though, may soon change the government's mind, as a passenger aboard a flight from China was diagnosed with the illness in Seattle, Washington. The passenger was quickly quarantined, but it was determined that they'd come in close enough proximity to at least 16 other unnamed individuals before being discovered. At the time of this episode's writing, an American college student studying at Texas A&M University was suspected of having been infected, which might mean that hundreds of other students were also exposed. By the time this episode is live on YouTube, you're probably watching it from an underground bunker somewhere, as the virus has decimated humanity and the survivors are forced to flee the surface and avoid extinction. All we could say is, hey, it's been a wild ride, thanks for the likes and shares. But how do you know if you're infected and harboring a potentially civilization-destroying virus? The virus is airborne, meaning it can be transmitted via coughing or sneezing directly onto another person. The exact transmission methods are still unclear, though a Chinese victim spread it to 14 hospital workers while being treated. Symptoms of this new coronavirus include coughing, sore throat, chest pains, typical flu or cold symptoms. This makes it difficult to ascertain if what you've caught is the hottest new deadly disease or just a boring old cold. Advanced symptoms, though, include extreme difficulty breathing, intense chest pain, and a loss of greater intellectual functions, followed by an appetite for the human flesh. Okay, fine, there are no confirmed zombies yet, but we just say give it time. The real question though is, are you even at risk of being infected? Well, if you're living in China, then yes, you definitely are. But infection is only seen as a serious health risk if you happen to be elderly and with a compromised immune system. Like many other diseases, the virus is a greater threat to the sick and old of a population, or so we used to think, because a stunning new development has turned that assumption on its head. On January 23rd, a completely healthy young Chinese man who was living 1,500 miles from the outbreak's epicenter became the 26th victim of the virus. As the virus continues its rampage, Chinese hospitals have become overcrowded, supplies have run low, and doctors are reaching their breaking point. To add to Chinese tensions, the government has canceled all temple fairs and festivals in many Chinese cities in order to limit large crowds and the spread of the disease. In a bid to quell fears, the Chinese state broadcaster aired footage from a large spring festival banquet in Beijing, attended by President Xi Jinping and top Communist Party leaders. Because if there's anything that reassures a panicked public, it's showing top government officials enjoying a nice banquet, while the public's own festivals have been canceled and they can't check into hospitals because they're overcrowded. The virus has now spread well outside of China's borders and is popping up in Thailand, Taiwan, Japan, South Korea, Vietnam, the US, and Singapore. Given the wide dispersion of the virus, it's only a matter of time until it spreads across the rest of the world. And while officials have not been too concerned until now, the death of a formerly perfectly healthy young man has many reconsidering the threat to the world's population. With mankind's reign quickly coming to an end, maybe you should enjoy another one of our awesome videos before we're all forced to live underground like sewer rats. Click on this video over here, or maybe you'd prefer this other one instead. You know what, why not both? Life's short anyway.